Hello, welcome back. In the previous video, we learnt about prepositions. In this video, we'll learn about conjunction. So what is a conjunction? A conjunction joins two words, phrases or clauses. Examples of conjunctions: and, but, or, while, because, neither, either. Let's look at this example. Rahul wants to go for a movie, but he has no money. So here the conjunction is but. Let us look at one more example. Mary and John are very good friends. Here, and is a conjunction. I wanted to come, but I could not because it rained heavily. So, what is the sentence? I wanted to come, but I could not because it was raining heavily. So here I am using two conjunctions. One is because, the another one is but. I saw your brother while returning from tuition classes. I saw your brother while returning from tuition classes. So here, what while is doing? It is joining two different clauses. I saw your brother. When I saw your brother, while returning from tuition. So, I saw your brother, one, then returning from tuition, second clause. So both clauses, while is joining. I want to buy this shirt. I want to buy this shirt, but it is very costly. So here again, look at the example. I want to buy this shirt. I am interested in this buying in this shirt, but I am not buying. Why I am not buying? Because it is costly. Give me red or blue pen. So here I am giving an option. I am giving red or blue. So these are some of the simple conjunctions. Next, let us look at interjection. So what is an interjection? Interjection is a word used to express emotions like wow, superb, oops, alas, hooray, we won the match, heard about your new venture, congratulations, oops, it hurt me, ouch. It is also an interjection. So interjections are used to express sudden emotions. It could be a happy news, it could be a sad news, it could be a shock, anything. So that's it, my friends. There's a little left out about conjunction and interjection. So in this video, I briefly covered what is interjection and what is a conjunction. It's a very brief video, I can say. In the next video, we'll discuss about singular and plural. The next video means in this only, continue, I am continuing. So what is singular and plural? Singular means just one, and plural is anything more than one. In nouns, there are two, regular and irregular. look at what are regular and what are irregular. So most singular nouns form the plurals by adding s. Look at the examples: bottle, bottles; book, books; table, tables; river, rivers; computer, computers. So bottle is a singular noun, bottles plural. For nouns that end in ch, x, sh or s sounds, add es. For example, bus, buses; watch, watches; wish, wishes; box, boxes; bush, bushes. So if a noun ends with ch, x, sh or s sounds like bus, so sound is s there. For those, to make plural we have to add es. So singular and plural, what you have to remember: when you talk about singular, we use is, es. When you talk about plural, we use are, er. For example, if there is only one book on the table, if there is only one book on the table, then how I will say? There is a book on the table. Suppose if there are more books, many, say maybe 3, 4, 5, any number, then how I will say? There are many books on the table. So R I am using. If it is only one, I will say there is only one computer in the room. There is only one computer in the room. Suppose if many computers, then how I will say? There are many computers in the room. So when you talk about singular, you have to use helping verb is, is, is. When you talk about plural, then you have to use are, helping verb are. Similarly, if I have to say I was, so I, only one person, so was I am using, past tense was, present I am in Bangalore, I was in Bangalore. Suppose plural, more than one person, more than 1, 2, 3 idre, then what we will say? They are in Bangalore, present, they are in Bangalore. Past, they were, were, they were in Bangalore. So this is a brief explanation about regular nouns. Then a singular noun ending in a consonant, consonant C, penny, Y is a consonant, baby, Y is a consonant, city, Y is a consonant, duty, there again Y is a consonant, library, again Y is a consonant, even a previous letter before Y, what is there? N, B, T, duty, T, library, R, all those letters are consonant. Then what we will do, to make them plural, we add like this: IES, baby, 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 that is singular. To make it plural, BABIES, babies. Library, 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 singular. To make it plural, libraries, LIBRARIES. These are examples of irregular nouns. There are some irregular noun plurals. The most common ones are listed below. Woman, W-O-M-A-N, woman is singular. Woman is plural. So why these are called irregular? Because we are not adding ES or S or IES to make them plural. The letters are getting interchanged, but we are not adding anything extra at the end. Woman, woman. Child is singular. Children, plural. Tooth, singular. Teeth, plural. Foot, singular. Feet, plural. Person, singular. People, plural. For example, if I have to say, one of my friend, say for example, Raghavendra. So how I will say, Raghavendra is a nice person, because I am talking about only one. So I will say, Raghavendra is a nice person. Suppose if I have to speak about many, more than one, then I will say, they are nice people. They are, T-H-E-Y, T-H-E-Y, they are, A-R-E-R, they are nice people. Leaf, leaves. Half, halves. Wife, wives. Mouse, mice. Goose, geese. So these are irregular. And some are very special. Some nouns have the same form in the singular and the plural. Look at the example. Hair. Plural also, hair. Sheep. Plural also, sheep. Fish. Plural, fish. Deer. Deer. Aircraft. Aircraft. You look at any oil, hair oil advertisement, it will be written clearly, for beautiful long hair, use this so and so shampoo. For beautiful long hair, no hairs, no sheeps, no fishes, no deer. So there are some nouns which are special. So for them, singular and plural are same. So you should not get confused. So the more and more you read, you will understand. So when you read, what you have to do? You have to observe. You read any book, right from LKG, UKG books to PG level book, any magazine, newspaper, read a lot. The more you read, the more you understand about the language. It could be any language. I am not saying only English. It could be Kannada, Hindi, English, Telugu, Tamil, Malayalam, French, German, Russian, any language. If you want to improve, the first is you have to listen. You have to listen to the language. Second is you have to speak. The third is you have to read. And fourth is you have to write. So it is called as LSRW. So why I am telling this is, many of us, we complain. I studied in government school. I studied in Kannada medium school. I come from rural background. So my English is weak. So all these are all excuses which we give to ourselves. If you take my example, I am also completely studied in a Kannada medium government school. Right from first standard to 10th standard. 10 years I studied in most backward place in Karnataka, in a government school, a Kannada medium school. But from the past many years, I am teaching basic grammar and basic spoken classes, that is English spoken classes, to many students. So how that was possible? That is possible because I had put lot of efforts from many, many years to improve my English. It may be English speaking, English writing, English reading, or listening to English. So my request to all of you is, if you want to improve any language, you have to keep practicing. You have to keep writing, keep listening, keep reading, and keep speaking. Otherwise, you cannot. Dear friends, listen to me. The language is like learning cycling. So I will give world's best book, which tells you how to learn cycling in 10 days. How to learn cycling in 10 days. Or for example, how to learn swimming in 10 days. You will read whole book, you will read complete book, but you will not learn swimming, only by reading. If you want to learn swimming, you have to dive in the water. If you want to learn cycling, you have to sit on cycle and start pedaling. Similarly, learn any language. If you just go to some English classes, the language is not going to improve. It is a continuous process. You have to focus on four aspects of language. As I said already, LSRW, listening, speaking, reading, and writing. The more you do, the better your language will be. Any language, as I said, any language. Hope I am making sense here. So it is a very brief lesson about regular nouns, irregular nouns, prepositions, conjunctions, and interjections. I know this is a very broad subject. It cannot be covered in short videos. So if you want, you can mail me at Pramod, P-R-A-M-O-D, Pramod at pramodthecoach.in. I am very much happy to help you further. So this completes the previous video. In the next video, we'll continue with time and tenses. Thank you.